Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, of course, today we're going to start by hitting create new 3D design. Friends, today's project is going to be called Ruler, and it's going to be called Tube. A user reached out on one of my ruler videos saying they didn't know how to measure the inside of a tube. Well, the first thing I would tell you is that if you're really using the tube, it's based on your numbers. So if I make this 20 and I make this 2, that means it's really 40 across, which of course I'll show you by bringing out the ruler. Let's pick a corner so you can see I dropped it right there. Then I'm going to take these and make them both 0. And 0. Let's click that again and actually type in the box, and you can see that shows us it is 40 across. Real quickly, I'm going to make this more round by sliding the sides all the way to 64. And then once again, because we know it's 2, that means we subtract 2 from each side, so we'd have 36. But if you really wanted to measure from a point, what you could do is drag this up, and because my grid is 1 and this was a measurement of 2, I can get it right on there. It does not show me that inside edge is 36, but it does show me that I am 2 in, so I learned that number. I could also do this where I brought out another shape, and if I just nudge this into place, I'm gonna do 0.1 nudge until it touches that edge of the inside of the shape. I can find out that that distance is 36. Once again, the ruler does not really work this way. I'm just showing you how I've used my understanding of the ruler to get a result that works for us. Now, another thing you could do is this: if you bring out a cylinder and put it inside a cylinder, I'm going to change the color just so it's easier to spot. I'm going to make it round, and then I'm going to make sure those two are lined up. L for align, center, and center. Now if I do Alt-Shift, I can stretch this out until it touches the very edge of that shape. You can see that I got very close to the actual number 36 by just doing that size about center trick. Once again, if you've got the real math, it's a lot cooler than doing that. Let me show you one last thing. I am going to import a piece. I found this on Thingiverse. I'm going to bring it in as millimeters. And let me show you how I would do these same things. I'm going to close this ruler for a second. And let's say my first trick to try and find the inside of this would be bring out a cylinder. Because of cruising, I can set it right in the middle. And then I'm going to just do the align. There's L for align, middle, middle. I'm going to click just on the orange one. Let's make it round. And then because it's centered, I can Alt, Shift, and stretch it out. Right when it gets to that edge, I can find out that it was about 26. So that's the way I would figure out that measurement. Of course, once you've got that, you can bring out your ruler. I'm going to line it up right here with one of these lines. And then if I grab these two, I can nudge it over into place. If I do shift nudge, that makes it a little quicker. And I can get it close to that exact measurement so that I can figure out the distance this is inside. So friends, once that's placed, I can click on it. And when I switch to this shape, you can see I can find out that the thickness of this wall is pretty close to 5.4 millimeters. So once again, it's just a way that you can use the ruler with cylinders or even things that you import as an STL. Once again, friends, I want to say thanks again for the awesome question. I hope you guys found this useful. Of course, it is not a perfect solution, but you can see how I would solve it. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.